struggling to take down the ancient. I believe the Sprout causing some problems. Oh, he's in the. Oh, what's going on?
Big boost. Echo in the fountain.
All right, okay. Thunder Predator, ladies and gentlemen.
And that's how you go out. With the Rampage, that's what they've been waiting for.
I mean, there's a reason why the fans love this squad. The buyback is to give it even more kills up for them as Thunder Predator.
It was against Puck, as well as Dark Willow and Monkey King.
Yeah, back into this is a big team fight side off at the river and sending up with Real the Reno Blood and aim for time lapse at the last second and Real Cat away. They will be back at the same time. The rest of Team Nigma just pushing in to the high ground. They go leading by Miracle. They're trying to slow him down. Sinkill is walking away first. Nothing to say. Say hey, back, back. But no, going in once again by that arm and turn on the Wukong Commander.
Huge coil.
Damage. Oh, and eclipse all the damage in the world down to a small area for Team Nigma. They're being baited inside. To the plates, PTSD LTD belongs, and it's four down for Team Nigmas. It's time to put you in two.
They'll go straight onto Dream. PYW there with the Hex, but there's your charge out. Immersion making sure he's safe. BKB committed. Dream is not going to die. He'll go right for the egg, bursting that down. DY, he's gone, and so is PYW. Now the black hole out. Afterlife holding down three, and that means they are probably going to melt. They'll lose Afterlife, but doesn't matter. Ori's dead. Poyo, he's trying to fight, but he's going to lose his first life.
Performance so far, 6-3-26. Team fight might break out though. Miracle jump in on the back line. They found Ori. BKB popped as well. Soaking him dry. Supernova. A bit away from Weehaw. He's gonna be careful how far he goes. And old 11's gonna try and counter up. They got the clips as well. Weehaw's gonna end up falling. He went way too far away from the rest of the team. And now Radiant, can they find any more killers as well? Old 11 looking to try and get the jump. Nigma actually sticking around, popping the refresher. GH has his second round of the ultimate. It's gonna dive on in. Abaddon falling low, but now with the super over, Puyo's gonna jump in the X-Mall. The Sun, no, look at all the damage with the Sun Ray. They'll burn him down. Troll tries to get the ultimate up, but it will not matter even without Weak Harbor. Uh-oh, Puyo gets a little light back thanks to the ultimate. They'll turn, losing another core, but the carry, the real one, it's GH on the Phoenix, gets a double. Another rest of Nigma looking to clean up. PYW chased down. Troll's got no buyback. Four will drop.
Three IOs?
Yeah.
No, it doesn't matter how many IOs because they have no hands. Oh, three-man coil, Supernova.
Oh my god.
Wow. Okay, and that is going in. All dropping by low with the damage on Puck as well. And that is a triple kill on this whip. This whip is shining brighter than my future.
And they're in. They're in. They're ready to do. Gambit, they have one more fight. That's all they got.
What can Afterlife pull off? Already Boxy starting off the action. Jumping in Afterlife. He's going to go with the black hole. He's only caught Insania for now. Then the Cataclysm
and he
just tears through him.
That's it.
The Refresher Cataclysm. It's all too much. 2 cents of that insane amount of pure damage just wipes ASM Gambit out of the game. No one's out and down. As Liquid, they've got the whole team alive to keep pushing on. GG is called.
Yeah, that
as
was
Liquid
such
will hold
a
on.
Good pickup.
Now they're going to go for a smoke. They know that Aster's going to be on their way over. They want to try and catch them by surprise.
Oh, good position
over
from Lando.
Throw to MVG. He's able to get it on the three of them. A beautiful jump for the Shaker. Comes in, takes Lando out of the fight. Now with the BKB up for Nico, baby, he's ready for the cleanup. He takes down Mad, runs down XXS. Is three dead on Aster. And now with a further catch, they might even be able to find Mone. Mone's trying for the TP out. Have they got the damage? They don't. Mone
he
will escape.
Man,
really close the gap on Nico, baby.
He on this credit on Mad. Got the good Yule Scepter.
See what they can do with this, Mad. He's able to dive away. White Album just laying down the Dream Coil, stopping Alliance from initially chasing any further. They're still trying to go for Mad. They'll pop the Supernova. The arena's out. XXS is going to try
Fisher.
And turn. Because BKB is back up. He's able to get the spear connection onto Hanskin. Pins him straight over the wall. S4 comes in with the roar onto Mone. So they bring the double ladder. He's in. He's been able to find the black hole and FNG jumps
everyone.
Into it. Ladder again. Every single time.
Now Ladder is just too good at Dota. He just caught four people. That's a
skill can tell. Try and clear out these units. Here comes the jump in. Leo right in on to the Titan. Now the black hole moves. He's caught three.
Oh.
This is really, really bad news for the side of Alliances. They just get completely wiped. Oh, this Enigma moves.
Ori, Astral Sept, another one going to be up in a couple seconds here. E-Blade stops the damage from DeBill. Old Eleven's coming back over as well, but a nice Astral Sep. Snowball still flying on fault. They cut the tree. No! Monkey King! He's still got the BKB along with the Wukong Command, but they chuck him up in the counter! There go PYW! It doesn't matter. Monkey will fall for the root. DeBill pops the BKB. Age is going to get dealt with. The BKB completely wasted, but Old Eleven standing his ground. Deals with the Marana.
McKay's cross strength is shortly going to be coming to an end. Leslau's in. Beats down. Quite for Quite for out of the game. Got a buyback of anyone trying to get the second black goal is in! He's got the three of them! McKay, it does! He's got the damage! The PA goes down! Tiger with the black holes holding on for this game! As they've got a chance here, they're continuing to stay in the action, Liquid, thanks to the power of Tiger.
All the buybacks, the only one who bought back pretty much is Tiger. Like,
and along with that double golem anyway, you're going to be held down for a long time, true BKB.
This Chuck, so confident to move up and get the tier 3 tower, but now they may make him pay for it. The spear back, the golem has been dropped into the back wall. They've got everybody in there. The Omnisat just ripping them to shreds. Ori, he'll buy back immediately, and so will Old Eleven. PYW, he's gone. How do you stop this Rax being taken? Static Storm, they've caught the Jug. There's no follow-up to it. He's still hitting the Rax. He still has the Aegis.
Juggernaut, so he feels pretty safe just split pushing. Like, it's being pinged out. Like, tier 3, Arteezy drops down to healing ward.
Oh, Masteron. He tries to get the catch here. He's not going to be able to do so. Blade Fury's out instantly. Crit trying to get in on the front. Gets the Magnetize down, but the Spike Carapace will keep him held on the high ground. Crit goes down. Rest of EG starts to step back. Your setup's there. Ahmed zips over the arenas. Down there's the Omnisend from Arteezy. And with the Battle Fury, it's cleaving through them all. He takes down Masteros, takes down Jabs up for the high ground. They get the catch on CJ as well. As EG take down four.
Where does it come from Dire side?
I agree. That's my main issue. In fact, speaking of, they might have their chance to show us now. Raven going to run away. He's not ready yet, but Skemmer's going to chase him down. The regen might be a little bit too high. Yopage will continue to roll through and they'll find DJ instead. Roll, not quite on target, but it won't matter. They should be able to get this. The Raven now going to turn around with the stun out and the
Hoopstop.
Masteros controls them up. And Jabs, he lets them know about it. You should have known better. It's the puck. They've got another play hard. He's gone and Fnatic. Suddenly, they'll get Raven involved. A triple kill on the elf.
Deals so much damage right now. They have a Lotus Orb. They have a Berserk Potion.
He's going to be out of force. Out of buyback.
That's also completely fine.
He's going to jump in. See if he can start something off. Quake for trying to move forward as well. They've got the concoction cooked up. They throw it over towards Mickey. Mickey's in trouble. He needs out the splitter. Comes out huge. Just to grab the ball. They're both cores down as soon as they return to the fight. It's over. GG is called as Mickey and Quake for out of the game yet again without buybacks.
Oh, that was such a clutch play. You know, Foxy, he goes in, lands a two-man coil, but it's
RG, just... they're going to try for the jump. JT. So not to Arteezy. Over to the side, though. The Dream Core's down. Chris having to come in with the Rolling Thunder. Ollie's, he's getting taken out. Low fly with a follow. Ravage. Ollie's gone. Karkin's gone as well. The Rolling Thunder continues to lock down Emos. Emos dead out of the game. They're going to call it. It's GG as EG with a fantastic start to the day here. This game won.
We all know how good my man is.
Oh, he missed the
Yules. But it's still enough to get the kill there.
That's a little bit of a surprise as they start to maybe get Old Eleven. However, they're going to lose Januel as Rolling Thunder comes through. PYW still alive for the moment, but the Aether Remnant lands as well as the Rolling Thunder coming through on a PYW. They get the Thunder, the Shadow Shaman, and Old Eleven still going to move forward. They've got the Omnislide, Lotus Oath used as well as the Ghost Scepter. Blade Fury right on top of death. They will kill off the Lashrak. Damage done to Old Eleven, but every time I talk about him, it feels like he's not dying. And
back.
As I say that, I jinx it.
Triple
coil. Coil on a three. And now Vici, it's back and forth. It's in and out. They're trying to find an answer here. Omni Slash ends up getting used. But you're trying to get the kill here onto the Medusa. And he's got the Swift Slash. They'll get the kill onto Nabil. They'll take out Play Hard. Triple kill for Poyoyo. Can they make it one more?
Trying to get some damage in on a GPK. This BKB is about to run out in a second, but does GPK really want to turn on this? It's not looking like
good Ravage.
The Ravage, that's going to land on the Death Prophet as well.
Check
the
out!
Now they're going to look over to get even more. The Shackle lands on a Bolt. They get the gun to GPK as well. DM! I mean, this is looking
Abed Storm wants to jump in. Silence online. Abed has a blade.
Abed, he's committing very close. They're going to turn. They've got the chains. The Root setting up onto Abed. Abed hangs up. The finger comes out. Abed's gone. The dagger from Arteezy will bring down Kaka. So it's a one for one. But IG still with the strength to push back EG away from the pick.
Rolling Thunder is available.
Can they go for any sort of steal? Crit, he's going to try and start
this
something off.
This is a good Rolling Thunder.
He's going to get a perfect angle here on the three of them. RTD jumping in as well. They're bringing the troll down low. They'll take down Fly for the Rolling Thunder. Bounces over to Emo. Emo pops the side fish, jumps out. Ferocious.
Arteezy gets it.
Arteezy's able to pick up the Aegis. JT's got to run, but he can't. As Fly will take him down. EG with a perfect fight around the pit as Crit gets the exact time to jump.